Good day! I'm back, and it is, let's turn this down some. It is time to go fight Martyr Logarius, and it's been a while since I've danced with the old man, so I don't know if I'm gonna beat him the first try or not. I do think... I had a feeling I'd forgotten something back here. I'm just kidding. I was just wandering around and happened to see it. My weapon, I believe, is more powerful than it was the first time I fought him, but it still doesn't change the fact that he is a very strong enemy that moves very fast, and when he gets mad towards the end of the fight, he has some particularly nasty attacks. The good news is that, assuming that your timing is decent, you can get parries in on him throughout the fight and do some pretty good damage. Ken 10, baby. Hanging on to those. He's definitely more of a, I'd call it a hit and run type boss, where you want to get him a couple of times and then just back away. And he's got a couple of magic spells where he'll throw some skulls out at you, and he's got another one where he throws a big slow-moving skull and then kind of swings his weapon and explodes it. And then he's got another one where he drops a sword in the ground and it just shoots more swords at you, so you gotta run and break the sword. And then of course he has his melee attacks. So anyways, here we go. A very cool cutscene. So he's got this big slow-moving attack he's gonna do, that you can... Here it goes. So these are his little skull attacks. And that one is a slow-moving one. So the big slow moving one, if you see it, you can just kind of hide or run away from it. If you see the big single skull he shoots out, go to the left because it blows up to the right, right there. And those you kind of have to just get between them or go to the side of them. Too slow. You can backstab them there. Those are kind of hard to dodge. I think you can parry that though. Assuming. Okay, sword's going down. Not so fast. Bullet deflect off him? It did. Yeah, no matter, he's dead. Okay, so I think knowing his attacks was a huge help then, because I had to learn him the hard way at first. It took me about three or four attempts to beat him the first time. So yeah. Knowing his attacks is, I mean, they hit so hard. If you don't know them, then they can really make the fight hard. But you know, once you know what they are, how to avoid them, what the tells are, what they're gonna be, turns out it really wasn't nearly as hard as I thought it would be. So, anyways, we picked up his crown and. Yet one more secret in this place. King in the castle, king in the castle. So wearing the crown near his throne reveals the other, just the big secret of this area. This awesome area. This is so cool. It's a shame you don't get to get a sweet set of armor like that. But it totally would not fit at all with any of the, I guess, the lore of the game.
Visitor, I claim no subjects, but here lieth our throne. Kneel afore us, or get thee gone. Visitor, moon-scented hunter. I am Annalise, queen of Castle Kanehurst. Ruler of the Vile Bloods, and sworn enemy of the Church. Yet our people are murdered, and we are prisoner to this wretched mask. What is it thou art in search of? Well, well. An odd hunter thou art indeed. We've tired of these piteous nights. Share in our plight, and take oath against the Church. If thou wouldst this path walk, I prithee, partake of my rotted blood. Very well. Drink deep of our blood. Feel the spreading corruption burn. Now, thou art too a Vile Blood. We two, the very last on this earth. We await thy return for the
okay. Trying to see if you could actually see her face. It's almost like there's just a skull under there. So hard to see. I mean, it's like there's not really a face model there at all. But the part kind of sunk in below the little visor thing made me think that that was actually her face behind there, but it looks like it's actually part of the helmet too. So I think these guys are actually just, I think they're actually vampires. And over here is another summons for the castle. And if you recall, far, far back in the Cathedral Ward, there is, what's his name? Alfred? I think it's Alfred, with the Logarius wheel. He said that he was fighting the Vile Bloods, and he didn't have a way to get to Cainhurst. So, if you kind of put two and two together, you
home, good hunt.
Probably guess it's
it you desire?
We can give him the summons and get his quest line moving along a little bit more.
Very well, let me.
So that's our next stop. Uh-oh, and somebody's missing. And somebody. Is leaking. Chapel Bra. Give it to me straight.
Kind hunter. The old girl. The old girl you sent over. She's dead. Killed. Stone dead. Why? Must have been a beast, right? Or do you think someone out there could... I just don't... Oh... Well... I do know. It's my fault. Oh my... Was it a beast? Or could someone from outside have come in and... Oh, just...
Okay. So we'll go follow that blood trail here in a minute. But first... The unfortunate fate that Granny has met. Collecting ingredients for my sedatives. It was you, wasn't it? Should have known. Okay.
Your light bar see through? I did not. I learned it.
And are you still crazy? Yep. Okay. So Ligarius guy. Alfred, he's gonna be up, right past the courtyard with the two big pimps. So I'm not really gonna bother fighting anybody. Don't really drop enough souls at this point, except for these guys. One shot. Even still, at 1300, is kind of a drop in the bucket compared to what the enemies at Murgaz Loth are dropping. Given where this area is, though, it really shouldn't be a surprise at this. Okay.
Oh, good to see you safe. Now, let's think up something to discuss. Just tell me what piques your interest. Aha! Is that the sigil of Kanehurst? I've heard tell of Kanehurst nobles and their amusingly pompous invitations. Wonderful! I thank you profusely. I will depart immediately, but first, a token of my gratitude. Ah, I feel my master's hand at work. Praise the good blood, and let us cleanse these tarnished streets. It has been an honor, but I must say goodbye. Let us cleanse, and may the good...
Okay, so that part for his quest is done, so I'm going to go investigate the blood trail and let Van Helsing go do his thing in the vampire area, Kanehurst. And we'll catch up with him in a little bit. Here she is, and that thing came out of her. Now, you can leave him alone, but she has a very important quest item that we need. So, there we go. Some fancy shoes. So, yeah. That happened. Anyways, we have, I believe, it's consumable. We have two of them. Oh, and the Wheel Hunter badge. It gives you access to the Lugarius wheel weapon, which is literally just a giant wagon wheel. It's really hard though. It's a really strong weapon. Okay. Now the next order of business is Murgo's wet nurse. The next to last boss of the game. If you're not counting your unique chalice dungeon bosses. Which I think that there's two unique chalice dungeon bosses needed for the platinum trophy. Oh good, they're finally one-shotting that dog. So because I unlocked this elevator shortcut, I'll have to fool with going past the Shadows of Yharnam, the pigs, or anything like that. I just got in the way. Went the wrong way. I'm just hoping they don't attack her. They probably would have left me alone if I hadn't gone down there. I wonder if this does anything. I don't think it does. I haven't read anything on the wiki, so it probably doesn't. So, kind of guess what the deal with that is. I need... I'll be back in a second. I need some elemental buffage for my weapon for this fight. $20,000, it's getting there. It seems like you have like a 50-50 chance of one of the pigs seeing you. Okay. Headed back.
Welcome. Very well.
Oh, so close.
Very well.
I need 50, right around 59,000.
Farewell, good hunter.
So, there we go.
Welcome. Very well.
Oh, before I forget, Got that vile blood rune. Or it's technically a constant heal near death. I wonder if I have that equipped if he'll attack me. I'll give it a shot. Let's see, so more of this rules. I want that. Okay. Because this is definitely a boss where you just... Actually, I'll swap the other one too. Yes. So let's see how many attacks I get out of this. Attacks. All right. Okay, so Mirga's Wet Nurse is basically a kind of a DPS check, if that makes any sense. Once she gets to a certain point in her health, the fight gets a lot harder because she'll start to spawn clones and kind of engulf the whole area with smoke so you really can't see. And she's pretty much defenseless if you get behind her. And if you can get behind her and just start wailing on her with the R1 spam, you can just do insane damage. And that's what I did the first time I fought her, and she actually didn't even make it to that phase of the fight because I killed her so fast. So that's the goal, is to repeat that, but this time gonna have the weapon buffed and the beast blood pellet for even more damage, so it should be interesting to see what happens here. Okay, so... No.
Silence yourself, child. The beast is gone.
And we have the third piece. So yeah, as you can see, when I was able to get behind her, pretty much defenseless. Her only defense was to... Good day. Her only defense was basically to teleport away from me. Coward. And so... At this point, you're technically supposed to beat the game. Oh, come on. You're technically supposed to go beat the game at this point. But there's, there's some stuff to do in the Chalice Dungeons before, so I'll go ahead and show you the hot mess in the dream. Just chilling.
Good hunter, you have come.
This is fine.
Dawn will soon break. This night and this dream will end. Gammon awaits you at the foot of the great tree. Very well. Farewell, good hunt.
Okay, so we have a couple options here. You can either check and see if this thing needs to be repaired. Just a, maybe. I'll hang on to those. How many chunks do I have? So you can either elect to go to the Chalice Dungeons, or you can go into this newly unlocked area and talk to Gearman and decide how you want to end the game. Or what I'm about to do is go and check up on Alfred in Cainhurst.
Master, look, I've done it. I've done it. I've smashed and pounded and grounded this rotten siren into fleshy pink pulp. There, you filthy monstrosity. What good's your immortality now? Try stirring up trouble in this sorry state. All mangled and twisted, with every inside on the outside for all the world to see.
Ha And there's the Logarius wheel.
Oh, you, is it? Look at this. Thanks to you, I've done it. Well, isn't it wonderful? Now Master can be canonized as a true martyr. I've done it. I have. I've done it.
So, still moving, still not dead. Queenly flesh. I want the hat though. Give me. Oh. I see you're up here. I just want that. I want that helmet. Okay. So this is kind of the end of his quest line. You mean you can kill him, but the only thing he would drop would have been his wheel hunter badge and the wheel. So nothing really there. However, we can go and do something with this. If you recall, after fighting the Celestial Emissaries, the big gank squad of alien guys, we were up in the upper deck of the cathedral. Above where we fought Amelia. And where we still have to go kill the Bloody Crow of Cainhurst. Which I'm not looking forward to that. He whipped me up good last time. So if you remember, down the elevator there is a great one and a big. Oh, I forgot about him. Be gone. There's a great one down here, a Abritus. Damien of Minsus. I'll take a crack at her solo first. This place is awesome. Fight starts when you start swinging, just like with Rom. I wonder. Really? Nothing? Again, I haven't read about being able to do anything with this besides getting the moon rune down at the bottom of the Nightmare Mensis castle, so I guess this doesn't do anything. Anyways, there we go, let's see what happens. Wow, she hits hard. I wonder if she got glitched out or something. That was way too easy. She had to have glitched out. There's no way that was... There's no way it should be that easy. Okay, well... I guess that's that. And... last but not least, that's about it. Can offer the mushy pink flesh for the ROM statue. And that's, I guess, about it, as far as I'm aware. So. Alright, I'll tell you what. Got a few minutes before we hit the hour mark. I'm gonna give some more help here first.
Very well.
And grab this. Okay. Because if I do manage to parry this guy, I know I'm not going to be at full health, like, at all, so I'd like to get a little bit of health back from him. Three for three on killing bosses on the first attempt tonight, so... Let's see what happens. Definitely gonna not go into this too cocky. numbing mist? I think not. That felt good. Oh, that felt good. 4-4-4. So, he dropped a blood drag. And if you remember, way back in the windmill in the Lost Woods, or the Forbidden Woods, our initial Covenant guy, he wanted those.
Don't you ever listen to your elders. No matter. You did save my life. I don't seem to be apt for this life anymore. My glory days were long ago now. I know. Here. For you. This too is Hunter's work. But it bears no honor. A burden you may choose to carry. The decision is yours alone. Grow heavy. Let me rest a while. I'll be fine. Just wait.
So she's basically gonna die there, unfortunately. Anyways, we've gotten a couple of things from that whole sequence. Alright. Got two different Covenant badges. Alright, we got this one. It's basically a more powerful visceral. So I'll go ahead and grab that one, because I know that I'm going to be doing probably quite a bit of visceral attacks in the Chalice Dungeons. The real prize, though, is that right there. Increases your stamina regen. And got a couple minutes, I'm going to run to the Forbidden Woods. Squash this old blood drag. Yeah. We've got Chalice Dungeons, and of course, the DLC. So, the fun is far from over. But, unfortunately, for today, the video is. And, as always, I thank you for watching, checking out the video. Good day.